So let's check in now with Charles Djou, who is standing by with our Christine Ueno. Chris?
That's right, Joe. Charles Djou and his wife, Stacy, along with his children, giving KHON2 their first interview of the evening. And what do you think about the numbers?
Well, we feel very good. We know we're going up against an incumbent who's going to far and heavily outspend us. We knew we're going up against and have a tough, tough fight in front of us here. And yet, with an all-volunteer campaign heavily outspent, here we are toe-to-toe with the incumbent mayor. So we feel very, very good. And you know what? The thing is, we're going to move on to the general election. And this, the voter turnout was fairly low here in this primary. That we're going to build a broad coalition of Democrats, Republicans, Independents, because this race isn't about tearing our community apart. It's not about dividing our community upon partisan lines and turning our politics into the ugly rancor you see in Washington, D.C. Our campaign is going to be about bringing people together, about getting a mayor we trust. And that's what we're going to do here. And we're really, really excited about it here because we know we're going to go on to the general election and we're going to win this. We're going to win this and get a mayor that Honolulu deserves.
And when you talk about trust, you say the first step is the rail project.
Absolutely. We are going to fix this gigantic mess with the rail system here. We are going to have a mayor who's going to be honest with the people, who's going to tell it like it is. We're not going to have a mayor here with our campaign who hides behind excuses here. We're going to have a mayor who's actually going to take responsibility for the gross mismanagement, the $1 billion of overspending, the years of delay on this project, and we're going to get it done without breaking the backs of people's working families and our seniors here. Because I get it, I understand here that so many of our families here are struggling, and that we cannot just continue to take more and more and more money from the people every single time we have mismanagement going on by this current administration. And we're going to store a sense of trust here, because every single thing that the mayor has said about this project has been wrong. Every number, wrong. Every deadline, missed. Every promise, broken. And we deserve a much better, healthier, and stronger leadership at Honolulu Hale than what we're currently seeing right now.
We just heard incumbent Mayor Kirk Caldwell talking about rail going to Ala Moana. You would like to see it go to UH and possibly Waikiki.
Yes. Now, the mayor's, he's great at talk. The problem is here, he has no money, he has no plan. He wants to go on to Ala Moana at some future date that's unknown, with a funding source that we don't know about. He has no idea how to do this, and that is simply no way to run our city. And that's why you're seeing we have such a broad coalition here building behind us here. Because we're going to see here Democrats and Republicans, Independents coming together to really, truly make a difference here and really get a new mayor who's going to take ethics seriously, take his job seriously, and take and understand that this people here, we need a solution, but we don't have an unlimited amount of resources.
You told me earlier that it's time now to hit the reset button going into the general election. What does that mean in terms of strategy?
Yeah. Well, you know what? Going into this, we knew it was going to be very, very tough for us here. We were the challenger. We are the young upstart campaign here. We only had 68 days to pull this primary together. We knew going into this here, a primary election is going to favor the incumbent, because that's where, and he has all the advantages. He has all the appointed staff. He has a huge, huge war chest. But now here we are, after having been outspent 5-1, 6-1 here. We're going to be evenly matched. We're going in almost exactly the same into the general election, where it's going to be a broader electorate. It's not just going to be a very small electorate that favors the incumbent. And we're going to be able to communicate to the people here about this true, real need for change, for real leadership, and about restoring trust to Honolulu Hale.
Now, do you have a message for the incumbent mayor, as well as maybe Peter Carlisle?
Well, I wish both these gentlemen well. I mean, Peter Carlisle and Kirk Caldwell, I mean, they're good men. They have dedicated so much of their lives to public service. Where I disagree with them is on their public policies and leadership here of this city here. Their leadership should be done by example. Now, Peter, I look forward to working through in the next coming days here, and I look forward to bringing this message to the people of the city and county of Honolulu.
Has Peter told you that he would support you in the next step?
I haven't had a chance to talk to Peter yet here, but I look forward to having a good conversation with him.
And what's your message to the incumbent Mayor Kirk Caldwell?
Well, I look forward to seeing him on the campaign trail over the next several months here. We're going to have a very good, aggressive, spirited campaign, a campaign about responsibility, about leadership, about making sure that we get a mayor that Honolulu deserves.
Yeah. And you had officially just 2 months to campaign. You filed on the last day. What is your message to your supporters?
Thank you so very much to all my supporters here. We really pulled this campaign together at the last minute. It really has only been 2 months that we've had an opportunity to work hard here, to try to assemble this coalition here, to fight hard. And, you know, I think it's not me. It's all of my volunteers around me. They're the ones who did it here. They're the one who brought us to this point here, that we're head-to-head, toe-to-toe with the incumbent mayor, and we're going to go into the general election, and we're going to get a new mayor of the city and county of Honolulu next year. Yeah.
We have children, Allie, Nick, and Tori, as well as your wife, Stacy. What do you think about the numbers and how this campaign has been?
You know, like my husband said, he's been running for 2 months. So many people have come out. They have so much heart. They have so much that they're willing to put into this campaign. And it just, you know, my husband and I are so thankful for all that they've done, all that they're putting into the campaign. And I think it really reflects the concern of the people in the community about the direction of our city.
And do you get to rest at all tomorrow?
Well, I think my little one, their piano lessons, we'll go to church, and after that, right back to the campaign trail. We're going to fight hard, fight every single day until the November election here, and we look forward to bringing our message to the people here.
Now, before I let you go, Joe Moore in the studio would like to ask a question. Joe, go ahead.
I'm not sure the candidate can hear me, so you may have to relay this. Would you ask Mr. Djou how serious he is about wanting to convert rail to an elevated busway system all the way to the UH?
How serious you are in converting the rail system to an elevated bus system? I know that you had talked about that, but you also talked about being open to all alternatives.
Yes.
So is the elevated bus system number one?
Yes, it's something we do have to look at, but it's one of many things we have to look at. The concern here is we cannot spend to no end here. Look, the current plan that the mayor has is to stop everything at Middle Street and then figure out the rest after the election. Get it from a funding source that he hasn't described yet, at a timetable he has no idea of where it's going to come from here. The only truly bad plan out there is the plan being presented by the mayor. Honolulu deserves better. We deserve a system that doesn't just keep on going with billions of dollars over budget, years behind schedule, and then the mayor just saying, that's okay. I'm not okay with that. We cannot have leadership that says it's okay to take all the people's hard-working money and just give it the cost overruns here. We're going to do something different. We're going to do it, and we're going to do it a lot better than we see here today.
So again, you are very serious in using
yes,
and then converting it.
Yes, yes, yes. Look, we have got to take a look at this here. All of this has got to be taken a look at. All of it has got to be on the table. The only thing that doesn't make sense is the Caldwell plan of stopping it all in Middle Street and figuring our rest out later here. That doesn't make sense, and we're going to take him on that, and we're going to change this.
All right. Thank you so much, Charles Djou, for joining us for your very first interview of the night, along with Stacy, Children's, Nick, Allie, and Tori. Back to you in the studio, Joe.